every woman is a powerhouse of energy and high potential. But how far we have exploited that potential, that is what I doubt. I was a housewife and I had two children. My husband was a businessman. He's a businessman. So I had enough money. I had a big house, cars, everything I had. But I thought I want to do something of my own. I want to prove my whatever skills I had, I wanted to sharpen it. I want to prove that I can do something. So when I asked my husband, first, as usual, he said, "Why do you need?" So I didn't need, actually. But then I said, "I want to do." Then he said, you come to our office and help me. So I started going to V-Guard office, and it was our electronics, electrical, this, that. I didn't know anything about it. I did my degree in home science. And I had lots of hobbies. And I was good at dressmaking, but I had nothing to contribute. So after 1 year, I told him, "Your company is running very smoothly, and if I am not there, I think it will run better. So you better send me out." So finally, he agreed, and I just stopped going there. So then I thought, okay, I should be doing something. So I told him I want to start a business in clothes. Then he knew I was very passionate about creating dresses and designing. So he said, okay, I'll help you in whatever way I can. Then that's how I started. So there was this brand name, V-Star, which was registered trade name. So he said, "You can take this name. And there is one of my office lying idle there. I'll rent it out to you." I said, okay. I thought he just simply said renting out. I didn't think that he'll take rent from me. And also, he said, "I'll give you loan, 25 lakhs loan I'll give you, but you have to give me interest. Only bank interest I'm asking. I'm not asking any blade interest," he said. Okay, still I thought he will not collect interest from me also. And I started my business. I recruited 10 people, one tailor, one pattern maker, one embroidery person, one purchase, like that, 10 people I started. I didn't know anything about business. I told him, "I can make good dresses." He said, "You make dresses, I'll help you to sell it." That's how I started. And then I entered into the business, the market. As all of you know, market is very, very merciless. I thought everybody will like welcome me like this because the product is coming from V-Guard. So I'll have all, I was dreaming like that. But when I went to the market, they said, "No, nothing doing. None of the Kerala brands have succeeded so far, so we don't want your product." So that was like a blow on my face. Okay, then all my executive used to come. Some of them literally they cried, "Madam, nothing I can do. They're not even ready to see the samples." So then I was in a fix, what to do now? Okay, then I said, "Okay, let us try." So, but I had like a good support from my husband, and that's how. And he and I started making samples and selling and all that. After 4 or 5 months, the market started catching up. So I got orders, but then still it was not doing very well. But it just went on. After maybe, I think, for 5 years, some of our dealers asked, "Ma'am, why don't you make some innerwears?" So I said, "Why?" "Because it's not available. Only one brand is there, and their supply is very short. We have to pay advance, then only after 3 months they supply." Then said, "Okay, this is a good opportunity." Okay, I said, "I'll try." I didn't even tell my husband that I'm going to start this lingerie business. I started buying products and learning the patterns and all that. So then I thought, okay, and I visited some of the stores. They said the innerwears are of good quality. There is good market, you can try. So I tried it. And when I tried, the market was very acceptable actually. And there was only one or two brands, so I had to do advertisements. So I took some photo shoot. So photo shoot I took, and I started putting some hoardings also. I tried all the magazines, and none of the magazines said, all of them said, no, we can't put bra pictures in our magazines, nothing doing. So I thought, okay, I'll put hoardings for another disaster. My husband went to Rotary Club on the same day, and all his friends came around saying, oh, we saw your bra on the roadside, this, that. He was like, that day he came and gave me tight. What are you doing? What do you think you're doing? And people started writing letters to him. What do your wife is doing? What is she doing? Is this the business she's doing, this, that? I never knew it was such a bad business, or is it a dirty business? My God. Such a... Every day there was fight in the house. I said, now that I have started, I have to sustain it. I cannot just go back. Kochouseph, what stabilizer to you? That is bra to me. Nothing less and nothing more, I said. And after a lot of fight, finally he came down, and that's how I just... So one thing I can tell you, you cannot make everybody happy and do a business. Some people will be unhappy, that I'm sure. You cannot satisfy everything, everybody. So some people will be unhappy, that just leave it, or just try to pacify them. That's what you can do. Because people think all in different ways. Some are positive, some are negative. You cannot take everything. So whatever your mind says, you just do it. If you think what you are doing is right, just do it. That's it. When I'm talking about women, a woman, I said this, she has the duty of a mother, wife. She's a cook. She's a gardener. See, all the work she has to do. And when she starts the business, she has to look after the office also. So what happens, but nothing, no flaws should be there in her work. She has to be perfect. Cooking should be perfect. She should be teaching the children, doing everything. So to balance all this, it's very, very difficult. But one thing I can tell you, only a woman can balance all this together. Teaching the children, cooking, sending them food, sending husband food, washing the clothes, bathing the children. See, like she has 12 hands she works. Even I have done that. I have two boys. So, and during those days, only we, husbands, they don't usually help you in the kitchen or in the house. That's all your job. But now things have changed, and boys are trained well, either before or after marriage. After marriage, for sure, I'm sure. They'll really train you. So better you, the boys learn before the marriage. Otherwise, they'll teach you. That's it. Okay. Now, when we see, all girls and boys are there, but they're not actually treated like the same. Girls are treated in one way, boys are treated in another way. So girls, they are tuned to do all household works, washing, this, cleaning, cooking, everything. But boys, in my childhood, it was like that. Maybe now, I don't know, it has changed. Boys, they play, they go out with their friends, they enjoy. They do whatever they want. Girls are confined to the house or kitchen. So now I think what happened is, now when we look at the gender ratio, 88% of the girls, they are passed, but boys are only 79. When you look at the 12th CBSE exams, 92% of the girls have passed the exams, but only boys are only 90%. And the medicine seats, medicine, 70% of doctors pass out are girls, and only 30% is boys. But for engineering only, boys are over now. But these are here, I think, more girls. Yeah. Boys are more usually. But then, where are these girls going? I don't know. Because when you see the cross section in the business world or in any organizations, the proportion is not like this. Less of girls and more of boys. So, where are these girls going? So, I think. Girls' future, future is not really decided by herself. Maybe when she is young, it is her father, and when she's if there is no father, it's her brothers, and when she's married, it's her husband, isn't it? Without the husband's consent, can you go to work? Can you study for higher studies? Can you go? No. So I think that is one thing. It is decided by your men. So there always this patriarchal system is there. So generally, men decide in our house. Main decisions they take, and women are like they're supposed to be submissive. If a boy do something, they'll say, "Oh, he's smart. He's smart." If a girl do something smart, what do they say? She's over smart. She's over smart. So these are the These are the practices in our society. Girls are supposed to be submissive, silent, without making any noise, just silent creatures. And boys can do whatever they want. So now things are changing. I hope girls won't overtake boys. That's also not good, because it has to be a balanced way. And for a woman to become an entrepreneur, it is not a natural process in our culture. How many men will marry a businesswoman? I don't think many will marry, because they're not sure how much he'll get to see the wife inside the house. So he's not very sure. So that's all I don't know how many men will marry anyway. But now things are changing, as you said. But and the, also this one woman, if she wants to become an entrepreneur, it's not her own wish. She just cannot do that. She has to get the support from everybody. Now, I started my journey as 1995 as salwar kameez and Indian dresses, then ventured into this innerwears and men's innerwears, kids. Now we have expanded our market to Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, and Andhra, and also we export to Gulf countries. We have 14 production units, all 100% of them are women. We do in charitable organizations run by sisters in convents. So we have about 1,000 women families, 1,000 women working, and I could really uplift those 1,000 families. And now when I go there, all these women, they have their own two-wheelers. They come to work on two-wheelers, and they are very happy also. So after this, I thought I should do something to society. So I thought, okay, I'll make a group of entrepreneurs. I made a group with my friends who are in business, asked them to add their own friends. Like that, we did, in 3 months, it was 170 entrepreneurs. Now we have a group, so I thought, okay, we'll name the group, give a good name to the group, and we named Women Entrepreneurs Network. 170 women are there, and more women are coming to join this. And now they are going on adding women. Once in a month we have meeting, and some trainers will come, they'll speak. And there's a lot of business is happening in the group. There are bakers, there are garment makers, caterers, beauticians, skin doctors, CCTV camera business, carpets. I don't know. All varieties of business, business people are there, and they are all getting business also. So when I was a member of many organizations, business organizations like Confederation of Indian Industry, then Kerala Management Association, Kerala Chamber. So everywhere it was all men dominated, and we practically had to do nothing. We just go there, meet, and come back. So all decisions were taken by them, and we were sidelined. So I thought, okay, women should have our own organization. That's how we formed WEN. Now it is doing very well. Last week we had an event in association with the Indus entrepreneurs. So we, WEN and TAI together, had a grand program last week. It was so successful. We expected only 350 women, but men and women together. And we got, I think, 430 participants for that program. And it was jam-packed, and from morning till 6:30, it was very live, and everybody enjoyed. Such a beautiful program it was. So we now so many people, some people came from Trichur, some came from Calicut. So they said, we want to start when in our district. So that's what now the next level we are planning to take when to the next level. So the discussions are going on, and we are planning to start this in other districts. So I thought this is a good platform for every woman entrepreneur. We have training programs. And another thing is, it's a self-help group. Whatever you ask in this group, somebody will ask, I want a French tuition teacher, then 6 tuition teachers number is there. I want a psychologist, my child is having some problem in the school, 5, 6 psychologists. And I want a plumber, or my mother-in-law is sick, who is the best cardiac surgeon here. So whatever question you ask, it is there, answer is there. So this group has become so alive and so vibrant. So, and they are very friends, thick friends. Wherever I go, there are 5, 6 women. I don't know all of them. They come running, ma'am, we are from when, we are from when. So that is one good thing I could do. Even though I didn't deliberately wanted to do it, it just came up like that. So that is one thing we are doing. So what I would like to tell all of you is, once you decide, once you become successful, once you do your business well, then you have to give something to the society. So this is what I'm doing now. And that is one thing. Then another thing, everybody has to look after our health. So every day, 45 minutes, I do some exercise. And we all eat very little food. Only lunch we have, breakfast very little, dinner only fruits. So so I don't need a full-time servant. I don't have a full-time servant. My servant comes at 8:30 and goes at 3:30. So, and we are very happy, and we have freedom in the house. And our kitchen is very clean because we cook very little. So because you know what? Many of my friends' husbands died of heart attack. So what these women were doing, cooking chicken, making biryani, chili chicken, this, that, and feeding her husband, feeding in the morning, feeding lunch, feeding dinner. Finally, he got heart attack and died. Many of them. So I'll ask all the girls not to cook too much and feed your husbands. Eat minimum and do some exercise every day and keep up your body. I'm 65 plus. So that's what I have to tell you. Thank you so much.